good evening. How are you? Oh, the time is about 12:23 on Friday night, well, early Saturday morning. And I just wanted to talk to you about a few things. We have a lot going on today in society. We have, you know, race relations. We're dealing with a lot of different issues, natural catastrophes, things like that. Don't be moved by any of that. The Lord told us very plainly that these things were coming. And he said, but the end is not yet. So don't be surprised about anything that you might see in the media, or, you know, there was one issue with the government now talking about UFOs. Don't get off on all that. We still have a responsibility to preach, teach, and demonstrate the good news or the gospel of the kingdom of God. That's still the mission of the church. It has not changed. Society might change, but we still need to stay in the gospel kingdom of God vein. Don't get sideswiped by what you see. Some of us are just nothing but diversion. All right. So tonight I want to talk a little bit about the 10 virgins, and I'm just gonna get right into it. Get your Bible, Matthew chapter 25. Chapter 25. Then shall the kingdom of heaven be likened unto 10 virgins. Stop right there. When it says then in chapter 25, that means there was something preceded before that, before you got to chapter 25. So you have to go up and read chapter 24. You can start at verse 46 and go down to 51, but I want to keep moving for time. Then shall the kingdom of God, heaven be likened unto 10 virgins which took their lamps and went forth to meet the bridegroom. Five of them were wise, five of them were foolish. They that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them. But the five wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. While the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept. Verse 6, and at midnight there was a cry made, behold, the bridegroom cometh, go ye out to meet him. Verse 7, then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, give us of your oil, for our lamps are gone out. But the wise answered, saying, no, not so, lest there not be enough for us and for you, but rather you go to them that sell and buy for yourselves. And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and they that were ready went in with him to the marriage, and the door was shut. I want to stop there, because there's a lot of reading in this, but there's some things that I want to point out in this particular reading. The Bible, you can read the Bible, and that's good. Reading the Bible is good. But at some point, you need to study. The Bible never told us to read the Bible. 2 Timothy chapter 6, 3 and verse 16 says to study to show yourself approved. So we need to study this thing. So as you study the Bible, it goes from being the Bible to the Word. Now, the Word is rhema, which means that's a right now word that jumps off the page of the scripture. We call it revelation knowledge. It's something that you need, that your soul, your spirit man can feed off of, okay? And so as you study the Word, you're reading the Word, but at some point the Word starts reading you. So everything in this book is applicable. It's been applicable since the day that Jesus authored it. I mean, just everything. There's something for every scripture for every person. No matter what eons of time we're in, it's applicable now. So I want to show you that. Okay. First, the five foolish virgins thought that the bridegroom was coming back sooner than he actually was supposed to come back. And this is the reason why they didn't have extra oil. They already assumed he was coming back then. Well, you can go back even to some of the religious cults where they thought Jesus was going to come back at such and such a day, and some of them end up killing themselves. Heaven's Gate was an example of that. You see people thinking that Jesus is going to come back then, and so they didn't carry oil with that in their lamp. What that means, if you don't have any, you went dark. The knowledge that you need is not there. So they decided to carry oil in their lamp, but didn't carry any extra oil, okay? Number two, it was not the five ignorant virgins or the misinformed virgin. It was five foolish versions. What does this mean? It means that somebody told them, instructed them on how to get ready, and they still did not do it. Five foolish versions, okay? All right. So, the five wise were ready. Five foolish were not. When the cry was made, the five wise went in with the bridegroom and the door was shut. Five foolish had to go and buy extra oil to come back so they could see where they were going. Now, interesting to me is if their oil ran out before that cry was made, how are they able to go and find the oil so they can come back in the first place? If their lamp went out, it was going to take them some time to get down because they have no light to even get to the merchants to buy the oil. Never understood that part of the scripture. But here's what I want to point out. Because they did not prepare, it cost them more time. Because they did not prepare, it cost them more time. Preparation is a part of kingdom consciousness, that we are not supposed to live by the seat of our pants. We're not supposed to waste time. We're actually supposed to redeem time. And the way you redeem time is through preparation. You know, for some of you out there that kind of live from check to check, it's time to start thinking about a savings account. Put some money back, but you never know what's coming. Put something back. Okay, preparation. It may require that you go back and get an advanced degree. God's called you to do something, but in order to do that, you need this advanced degree. You need some training. That's called preparation. You go ahead and do that. They were foolish because they did not prepare. It's interesting because as I'm writing this down, the Holy Ghost reminded me that about the whole armor of God, Ephesians chapter 6, the whole armor of God, that you have the helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness, the belt shod with the loins girded with truth. But that foot, it said that the foot was the preparation of the gospel of peace. That's the only part of the armor that you got to prepare for. Come on. Prepare for. So people that have purpose in their life prepare. They even prepare to do nothing. When they want to go on vacation, they plan this thing out. They don't just prepare. They don't just go at a whim. Time is important. So you don't have a lot of time to waste. You're supposed to be doing something. You need to get to doing it. I'm talking from my own personal experience. I'm a musician, but most of my musical experience has been in church. But the Lord has put this on me to take it beyond just church, into the marketplace. For me, it's the educational system. Because I kind of see myself as a college professor. I feel like I sense that that's where I will end up, being a professor at a university. And I've got to prepare. That, you know what that means? I've got to get my sheet music out. I have to go back over my aria skill. Aria means it has skills having to do with your ear training. Get my sheet music out to play the organ, whether it's pipe organ or the Hammond organ. I've got to be able to teach theory. And all this, I've got to get these out, and I've got to be chewing on this. My degree is going to be in math. I'm pretty good with numbers, and I still got to train for that. So I'm preparing. See, we're preparing for the bridegroom to come, but one of the ways we must be ready, okay, for the bridegroom to come. So let me move on with that. You need to be prepared. Start preparing, okay. All right, number four, I want to put this out here. Give us your oil, for our lamps have gone out. So the five wise had more oil, five foolish did not. Five foolish said, give us some of your oil. And the five wise, this is not what they said. You know what? You a sister and brother in Christ. I'm going to give you my oil here. Just take it. Just take as much as you need. Uh-uh. The five wise say, no. There are some people that you're going to have to stop helping. You've been helping them and helping them and helping them and trying to get them going again, and they don't appreciate what you're doing. They don't even want your advice. Stop helping them. But what the wise did is gave them an instruction. And the instruction was this: go and buy for yourself. Go and buy for yourself. I'm not going to, here's how I'm going to help you out. I'm going to tell you how to get out of debt. I'm going to show you how to get from point A to point B. You see what I'm saying? There's some people that don't want your help. I can say that for my own personal life. There are people that want to help. And they just, you know, I said, well, consider this, because they didn't want it. And so I had to back off of them, because I got a purpose. And when you got a purpose, you got to be careful about who you're hanging out with. I'm not saying you got to befriend them. You can't say, well, I can't hang with you, we're not friends anymore. But if you got a purpose in your life, every moment in your day has purpose, which means it's got time. And you're going to have any time to waste. You ain't got time to talk about what y'all did 20 years ago. I remember when we did. Okay, that's fine. That was we talked about that for 5 minutes. Let's talk about the future. Well, I ain't nothing. Okay, well, I got to go. The five wise gave them an instruction. They did that. But when they came back, the door was shut. All right. So remember this. Some people you just cannot help. Okay? Some people you just have to let them go. Now, when the bridegroom came, five wise went in, right? And when they went in, the door was shut. Here comes the five fools and said, let us in. And the bridegroom said, I don't know you. I don't know you. I don't know you. Now, what? See the door as an opportunity. When you see doors in the Bible, when you see a scripture that says the word door, doors is an exit out of one place, but an entrance into another, or in reverse. You're leaving something going somewhere else, okay? Because the five foolish did not prepare, notice, the door was shut. That could have been an opportunity for you. Opportunity. Are you preparing for what God has for you in the form of opportunities? It may be in the form of a job promotion. It may be in the form of a scholarship or a grant. It may be in the form of whatever it may be. If you don't prepare when that opportunity comes, notice the door. Who shut the door? The virgins didn't shut the door. The bridegroom shut the door. Jesus will actually shut a door on you because you have not prepared. Get yourself together and prepare. Get around someone that has a pattern of preparation. You need that. And this is for somebody out there right now. You were supposed to write a book about your testimony, and you still have not written that book. And the reason why you haven't written that book is because you're hanging around with people that have never written a book. And so you don't have that stimulus there to excite you to go and do it. It's time to write the book. Tell your testimony in a book. Find a publisher. Find a book on how to write a book. Go to poetry reading. Find an author's online form and get involved. Stop playing church. Get the book going. Somebody say amen to that. All right. And here's my final note. I'm going to paraphrase 2 Kings chapter 3, verse 15. It was talking about David being a minstrel. The king Saul had an evil spirit on him, and he said, bring me a minstrel. Well, here comes David. David plays for him. The evil spirit left him. Now, I want you to get something. In King James Version, it said, bring me a minstrel. It didn't say, bring me the minstrel. A minstrel. A minstrel means there was more than one minstrel. David showed up because he was ready. If you have to get ready, you are not ready. I don't have to get ready. You got to be ready, okay? David was ready. That means there was other minstrels that heard that, but they hadn't practiced. They hadn't prepared. They haven't got their thesis statement written. So they have not prepared. Bring me a minstrel, and David had prepared, and he was ready. All right. So what's the takeaway? The takeaway is, when you don't prepare, it costs you more time. It also means that if you, sometimes there's people that you're helping that you need to stop helping. The five foolish asked for the oil. The wise said, I don't think so. There's just some people you need to back off, let them try to figure it out for themselves. Number three, the door was an opportunity. and the opportunity was open to the wise, those that had prepared, but it was closed to those that did not prepare. And that last thing I want to point out is that if you've got to get ready to do something, you are not ready to do it. You must be ready. That calls. So this whole idea is about preparation. There's all kind of revelations in that 10 virgins reading, but these are the things that I sensed I was directed to point this out to you. And so my final note is this: I don't want to assume that you didn't know the stuff that I'm talking about, because that'd be arrogance on my part. I want to assume that this is just a refresher course, that you've heard this before, and perhaps something that I said can be a blessing to you. Get on it. Get to school or college or whatever you need to do, and start preparing for your future. God bless you. Have a wonderful evening. Bye.